Now they want AF is to AC. All right. Let us see if you can. Anybody adjust the masses here? Okay, one of you tell. You can you tell? You completed now? Okay, three are set. You want to tell? Okay, she is asked. It's okay. B and C. Okay, at D 2 M. Okay, because of 1 is 2. All right. Is it sufficient? That's all now. We can tell very easily, right? Okay, that's it. This is 2M means AF is to FC would have been 1 is to 2. They want AF is to AC. Okay. So, first of all, I will write AF is to FC as 1 is to 2 and AF is to AC as 1 is to 3. Is it right? Okay, because this is a midpoint, we are taking two equal masses and here the sum of these two masses here. And because this is a midpoint of these two and that is 1 is to 1, if this mass is 2m, this mass has to be 2m. So, we could fix the masses. Okay. In fact, if somebody says join C and E and we can tell anything, like some other things also can be told. Okay. This is a method we want. Anybody could use some kind of Menilla's theorem here? What do I know here? Let me see. Yeah, I can take triangle ADC and line BF and do it. AF is to AC, how did I get? Okay. AF is to FC is 1 is to 2, clear to you? So, this is one part, this is two parts, right? Now, you tell me, what is AF is to AC? 1 is to 3 only, that's it. Okay. Let us see Menilla's method, same triangle ADC and I want to take line BEF. This line is dividing AD in what ratio? AE by ED. And the same B is dividing DC in the ratio BD by BC and CF by FE. First AD, next DC, next CF is equal to 1. AE by ED is 1 by 1. BD by BC, BD is 1 unit and BC is 2 units. CF by FA I want to find is 1. So, CF by FA is 2 by 1. So, two, then you can tell again same thing, right? Again AF is 2, AC is 1 is to 3. In fact, you can add 1 on both sides, see that. CF by FA plus 1 is equal to 2 by 1 plus 1. CF plus FA by FA is equal to 3 by 1. CF plus FA is CA. CA by FA is 3 by 1, which is AF by AC is 1 by 3. Okay, so we'll also do by vectors. I feel better than vectors, Menilla's method, and better than Menilla's method is using center of mass. Okay. All right, you copy this other method, we'll see in the next class. Whenever it is. 48, you equate I coefficient, J coefficient, and K coefficient. After the. Wait, wait. The main point is x, comma, y, comma, z should not be 0, comma, 0, comma, 0. Have you seen this kind of thing, x comma y comma z should not be 0 comma 0 comma 0 any time before? We have seen this in the beginning of first year in maths and determinants. Non-trivial solution. Non-trivial means x should not be 0, y should not be 0 and z should not be 0. Okay. So, whenever you have an equation x into something, y into something, z into something, but there no constant, constant is 0. Like the three equations, obviously x equal to 0, y equal to 0, z equal to 0 is a solution. Other than that, we want some other solution. That is only possible when delta is 0. The determinant should be 0. So take x coefficient, y coefficient, z coefficient in your three equations, take the det equal to 0, you will get. We can explain even by vectors way, how is that? Okay, I'll tell you how to do by vectors way. Bring RHS to LHS as it is, and keep x part as it is. You are going to get x into some vector, y into some vector, z into some vector equal to 0. But you are going to get some lambda here, some lambda here, some lambda here.
Yes,
right. But x, y, z, all three should not be 0. Right? Okay. That means these three vectors should be coplanar. Because if they are non-coplanar, how can you find a linear relationship between them? You can only find when all are 0. But they said they should not be 0. Means these three vectors are coplanar. Three vectors are coplanar means det equal to 0. Same det only will come again. So whether you do vectors way or a matrices way, you will get that det equal to 0 only. Okay, anyway, if somebody is not fully clear, in detail I'll explain in the next class. I'm sure those who have doubt, they understood. Okay. All right, we have next class. All right, thank you very much.